Ooh, I'm liking this salt and pepper, Ezio. This is nice. Whoa! Who is that? Hi, welcome to another episode of Bethany Talks About Stuff. I'm your host, Bethany F. DeVores, author of the Sea Addressing Chronicles, available from Amazon. And on that note, I'd like to say a special thank you to a friend of mine who knows who she is, but she gave me these adorable earrings, and they are little like replicas of my book. Isn't that cute? They're just adorable. Anyways, thank you. You know who you are. Today, we're talking about Assassin's Creed Revelations. So, as you know, I've been doing this retrospective of the Ezio trilogy in 2023. I originally played Assassin's Creed Valhalla. I had no idea what was going on, so a friend of mine sent me some videos to help me understand the backstory. And then I was still kind of confused, so I watched more videos, and a lot of the videos that I watched focused on Ezio Auditore, who is a great, great character. So I've been playing the trilogy and doing my take in 2023 of these older games and giving you my opinion, which is what I do. So, to briefly recap, Assassin's Creed 2, I liked it. I felt like it held up. Ezio is a great character, so it was good. I had a little problem with a plot issue in which at the end, he doesn't kill the big bad guy, but there was kind of no reason for not killing the big bad guy. Whatever. Assassin's Creed Brotherhood was a little bit better than Assassin's Creed 2 to me, mainly because Ezio has become a little more seasoned. He's a little more mature. By the end of Assassin's Creed 2, he was already, I think, 40 years old. Like, that is a very long-spanning game, time-wise. And you don't even really realize it until later. In Brotherhood, by the end of Brotherhood, I think he's 48. He's a little more seasoned, a little more just wise, a little sexier in my opinion. It was very good. Assassin's Creed Brotherhood, I would play again. So all that leads me to Assassin's Creed Revelations. And I want to tell you, I was very excited to play this game. I was ready.
And I'm ready to party!
And my friends who've played it, I noticed, all got real quiet. When I was like, man, I can't wait to play this. I can't wait. It looks so good. And they were like, okay. Everybody was super excited when I'm like, okay, I'm going to play Brotherhood now. They're like, yeah, you're going to love it. And then I was like, I'm going to go play Revelations now. And they're like, okay. So, yeah, I know it's hard to believe, but I have some feelings.
I just have a lot of feelings.
I don't normally do this quite so blatantly in the beginning of the show, but I was very underwhelmed. And let me explain to you why, I think you'll understand. So, we had this great cinematic trailer. Ezio's a little salt pepper, a little older, but he's still kicking butt and taking names, right? So cool to watch.
I'm ready for the fight and fate. Iron shards stuck in my head. The thunder of the drums dictate.
I actually saw that trailer before I really knew anything about the Ezio trilogy, and it was one of the things that convinced me that I wanted to play the trilogy, because I was like, man, that's cool. He is awesome, and I want to know more about this character. So I was really excited, and then I started actually playing it.
Did Yusuf Tazim send you? That sounds like one of his exaggerations.
See, he said you could show me the location of Niccolo Polo's former trading post.
Ah, you must be that Florenzale he's been yammering on about. Lothario?
Ezio.
that's not the same game. Now, don't get me wrong. I understand. Every cinematic trailer is not going to look like gameplay. That's just not a thing that's going to happen. At least not at this point. Even now, that's not a thing. I could take that with a grain of salt. But once I actually started playing, pros and cons. So I'm going to start with just giving you a little background if you haven't already played it. Of course, as always, spoilers! You need to be careful. I'm going to be talking about spoilers. This game was released in 2011. If spoilers are going to bother you in 2023, I'm sorry, but now is the time to turn away. So this game takes place in 1511 through 1512. So it's a shorter time period than the other two games. Ezio is currently 52 years old. And he has decided he wants to find this library at the old Assassin's Creed headquarters in Masayef. So it's like a stronghold, but it is now overrun by Templars. So he wants to go find this because it was a library with knowledge from the assassin's beginnings or early days. And it was at that time the assassins were being led by Altair, which was the character from the first game. The place is overrun with Templars, and then he finds out he has to have all these keys to open up the library and get to the knowledge inside. So herein already starts the problems. One is the plot is a little thinner. It doesn't grab you as much. In the first Ezio game, in Assassin's Creed 2, there was strong motivation for Ezio to be out for revenge. He was out to take down these Templars because they killed his father and brothers. And then he found out how evil they were, not just for that, but for all kinds of stuff. And he becomes dedicated to stopping that evil. So that was very, you could really dig into that. And then in Brotherhood, that thought continues because the big bad guy, for whatever reason, dummy Ezio, didn't kill him, even though he's killed 5,000 other people in the efforts to get to him. Whatever. That guy is still alive in Brotherhood, and his evil son and daughter also wreaking havoc, and they kill his uncle, and they kidnap his sort of girlfriend. Very clear and strong motivation for Ezio in Brotherhood. But then we get here and it's like, hey, I had a whim. I think we're going to look for this library. Oh no, Templars. I just wasn't as invested in this story, even though I love Ezio. And I knew there was going to be like a full romance. You know, he had romantic interests sort of in the other games. There was like a flashback romance to a character he'd been involved in the first game, but in my opinion, that was shoehorned in. The point is, I knew he was going to have a genuine like love interest that would, you know, run its course, like in a much more natural, nice way, except that when I then start to play the game, I'm like, this is boring. His love interest is boring. The motivation behind the game is boring.
Bored.
What?
Board. I didn't feel any connection to this. So there are other areas where I didn't feel connection. I'm going to get into all of that, but that's the main idea. He's there to try to get to this library. He feels like it's important to get this information. He does then get embroiled in some of the politics because the Templars are messing in politics, so he has to mess in the politics. That's typical, but it just wasn't as engaging. So the story was lackluster, in my opinion. One of the other things I didn't like about this game, I've kind of touched on, and I didn't like how old he looked. So Brotherhood ended 1507, right? Okay. In 1507, Ezio was 48 years old, a year older than me at the time of recording this video. Fine. It's looking a little wise. Still pretty good looking, enjoying that. Then we get to 1511. So 1497? No, 1507 to 1511, the man ages like 30 years. What? Why does he look like a werewolf? I don't understand what is happening right now. He couldn't have aged that quickly in that few of years. But I had some people tell me, well, you know, when I complained about this in real life, well, you know, he's an assassin and he's fighting all the time and he's lived a hard life, blah, blah, blah. Sure, but you think it'd catch up to him in that short time frame? And suddenly he'd go from being sexy, wise Ezio to being wolfman old guy Ezio. I don't think so. I'm not on board with this. He's 52. He's not 82. Even Altair in the flashbacks was a little more enjoyable at 82 than old man Ezio. So I didn't like the way they had him looking. And that was like a running theme. Now, I said in Brotherhood that I liked the little hints at, okay, he's in his late 40s and he's struggling a little bit more.
Beck.
Fine. I liked that. I thought it was cute. But here, it's like, even though it's only a few years later, it's like all of a sudden he's an old man. And they're like, hey, old man, about everything. You're so old.
When were you ever young?
So I was so annoyed through the whole game. That was actually distracting to me. He just doesn't look like Ezio. I mean, he does, but he doesn't. He doesn't look like Ezio should look at 52. And I'm going to point out, when everybody's like, well, he's had a rough time, he's gone through all this stuff. Okay, yeah. He's also got the Isu or Itsu or whatever, the DNA from the ones who came before. So isn't that kind of what makes him special to begin with? Like, he's got this connection to the ones who came before, so he can do these fantastic things. He's got this special eagle vision and all that. Shouldn't that make him, like, I don't know, stay at lack of a better term, stay a little fresher as he gets older? I don't know. I just think whoever wrote this game decided it was time to sunset Ezio and they wanted to declaw him. And they did. They dulled his fangs. He was not as tough, even though he was still tough. They made it like they were sunsetting this character. I just didn't like the way they did it. They kind of just made him dull. And at one point he says to his new, like, love interest,
who are you, Messere?
Only the most interesting man in your life.
Ah, che presuntuoso.
But I was like, that's awkward. Like, if that guy came into my shop and said, I'm the most interesting man in your life, I'd be like, ooh, you're creepy, get out. Like, it wasn't really cute. I mean, it was kind of cute, but it really wasn't cute. That's not what I want from Ezio. I know I say this all the time, and I'm a writer, so, and I'm not the best writer ever, but I always look at a story like this and think, here's where it went wrong, and I just would have done it so different. I agree, game 3 was probably time to let Ezio go into retirement, but I think it should have been done differently. Oh, the list continues. So, I didn't like some of the new characters. The main new character was Yusuf. He is basically leading the assassins in Constantinople. And he meets with Ezio right away, says, oh, we've been looking for you, mentor. We could really use your help. We want you to, you know, share your wisdom and train us.
Unless the legend is a lie, you are the man I long to meet. Renowned master and mentor. Ezio Auditore de la la la.
Prego.
Forgive me. I have a hard time remembering that Italian gibberish.
But then he proceeds to train Ezio on like 15 different things. And at one point he even says,
who is the mentor here, Ezio? I'm beginning to wonder.
And again, it was like so disrespectful to Ezio's character for them to do it that way. Certainly, I understand they had to introduce some new gameplay mechanics, so they were using that as a way to do that. Hey, here in Constantinople, we use bombs, and here we use this hook blade, and okay, I get that, but I don't know. I just found Yusuf to be deeply unlikable. While I know some people who played it really liked him, that was one of their actual things they liked about the game, I didn't like him. I kind of wanted to punch him in the face from like minute one. And I also hated that headband he wore. I just didn't like it. And let me tell you. So then at one point, Ezio Yusuf and other assassins have to dress as Italian minstrels to, like, as a disguise to get into a party to find their targets or whatever. And they're all wearing the little caps, you know, they're in full outfit wearing the little caps. Not Yusuf, he's still got his headband on.
I look ridiculous. I feel ridiculous.
He looks like Yusuf. There's no blending in like that, buddy. You're just you. So I didn't like Yusuf. And honestly, I kind of nothinged Sophia. So she had a couple of moments where she was kind of quick on her feet and had something funny to say.
Do you not feel the magnetismo?
I feel many things, Messere. Nausea above all.
But overall, I just found her kind of boring. And I'm like, Ezio is such a powerful and cool character. His love interest that he was going to end up with should have at least come close to that. Not in kicking butt mode, but in just being interesting and different. She's just boring. Again, kind of shoehorned in. Like, she was an Italian in Constantinople, and her story just didn't have anything to do with anything other than to be there to be his love interest and eventually be taken hostage. That leads me to my next con. Like, I really had problems with this game, y'all. And that is the city of Constantinople.
Welcome to Constantinia, Ezio, the crossroads of the world.
I don't have anything against Istanbul, Constantinople. Now it's Istanbul, not Constantinople. I don't have anything against the city itself. I do, however, find it to be not a great setting for Ezio. Like, it just didn't resonate with this in the game. It was a little bit smaller map, and I didn't connect with it. And I just felt like Ezio was so out of place, and it didn't work, especially after falling in love with Italy through Ezio. This just didn't seem to work for me. It just didn't work for me. The last thing I'm going to mention is a gameplay mechanic I didn't like that I know some people genuinely liked this. Like, this was an addition that they enjoyed. I had one person in particular tell me I loved those objectives. I hated them, in which you basically commanded troops of assassins and said, okay, I want snipers here, snipers here, snipers here. I want guys down here, want a cannon there. I want a barricade built over here.
Make your stand there. Make your stand there. Make your stand there. Make your stand there. Make your stand there.
I just didn't like it. It reminded me kind of Civilization, which I actually do like Civilization, but that's the thrust of the game. That's what I'm getting into. It's what I want, but I didn't appreciate it, or I just didn't enjoy it in Assassin's Creed Revelations. Like, it just didn't, again, it was out of place. So it just felt like the developers were going to sunset Ezio, and they did it in like the most boring way possible. I really felt like there could have been a much better way to do this. And so it was just not good. So, having said all that, I would like to talk about some of my pros. And then I'll talk about whether or not I think they outweigh the cons. So, pros. The gameplay is still fun. There are some tweaks to the gameplay that I think actually make it a little more fun. I enjoyed the hook blade. I enjoyed this little move where you got to like grab somebody and like flip over their back. That was kind of cool. I liked the zip lining stuff. That was fun. I didn't really care for the bombs, but I liked that you could use them if you wanted to. And Ezio is still a great character. So let me just be clear. I feel like the developers didn't do him justice story-wise, but he's still a great character. He still has some quips here and there. He's still fun.
The things I do to save the world surprise me time to time. Like learning how to play the lute and making these words rhyme.
And I liked some of his interactions with Sophia, but sometimes they were just a little cringy. But some of them were good, so I still liked that he had a genuine romance as opposed to passing flights of fancy, if that makes sense. I also liked the Altair stuff. Now, I did not like that at first. I was like, man, I don't want to play as Altair. I'd go back and play the first game. But actually, as the game went along, I began to actually like that. Now, that I felt that story was actually interesting and kind of important to the overall story. So I liked that. In some ways, I felt more connected to Altair's story than Ezio's. It's not good. But as a pro, it was interesting. I gotta, out of order, add to the cons, I'm not enjoying the modern day story. I'm not enjoying that. Still don't like Desmond, and this one we get daddy issues.
Daddy didn't love me!
Great. Anyway, I really don't have, off the top of my head, and even with my notes, and even going through and trying to just find some gameplay for the video, I just don't have a lot of extra pros. And I'm pretty disappointed. So overall, my overall feeling about Assassin's Creed Revelations, unfortunately, is that it was underwhelming. It was okay. It was a good enough game. In comparison to Assassin's Creed 2 and Brotherhood, it didn't stand up. I will not be playing it again. I didn't really enjoy it that much. It was okay. It wasn't horrible, but I got a little spoiled with the other two, and I feel like gameplay and story-wise, they were much stronger. This was a weak entry, and I was disappointed, frankly. I was just disappointed. I expected more, especially with that kick butt trailer, right? It was so good, and I was so excited. And in fact, before I knew anything or much about Ezio, I saw that trailer, and that Ezio in that trailer kind of inspired a character for a new story that I kind of started to work on, which I'll have to decide if it is too much Ezio or not. I don't think so, though, because I hadn't really watched any Ezio yet. I really didn't know much about him. I just knew that character in that trailer, and I was like, that is awesome. I'm loving this kick butt Silver Fox dude who's just laying everybody out. That was awesome. So that's a good thing that came out of it, but overall I'm disappointed. I'm not gonna lie. I really would have liked better. Do I think you should play Revelations? Well, if you haven't played it and you've played the other two in the Ezio trilogy, yeah, I think you should play it. Finish it out. It's not bad. It's still a good game. I'm probably not giving it a fair shake, to be honest, because I just got it so built up in my head. And I'm just kind of so in love with Ezio that I didn't feel like this did him justice. But if you don't have the same kind of emotional investment that I had, you probably would enjoy the game better. And there were some fun things, I just was disappointed. So that was a sad ending to the story arc of a great character. And it actually gets worse, because after that is the little short animated film. Oh, shoot. What's the name of it? When you buy the Ezio trilogy as a, like, together, it comes with this little actual live action movie about Ezio's father at the beginning of Assassin's Creed 2. And then at the end, there's a little animated movie about at the end of Ezio's life, which is, I didn't like it at all. In fact, it still left a bad taste in my mouth. I didn't like that at all. Like, whereas Revelations, I can say, well, it was underwhelming, but it was okay. I didn't like that at all. It just made Ezio into this grumpy old man.
Get off my lawn.
And I don't, after all he went through, finally settling down and realizing that devoting his entire life to this might not be the best thing, as Altair did, And that was basically the wisdom that Altair left, was that you do your part and then enjoy your life. And Ezio's like, you know what? I've done my part and now I'm going to enjoy my life. And then that little short movie made it like him enjoying his life was only a few more years. And again, I got to point out, the man was only 52. What? Whatever. Just disappointing. Anyway, I'm not giving up on the series, though. I would definitely recommend the entire Ezio trilogy. So overall, now that we're at the end, I would recommend the trilogy. Ezio is still one of the best video game characters ever, in my opinion. And I think it was worth the effort I put into it. No, I will not play Revelations again. I will never watch that little short movie again. Lineage, or I don't remember. I'll put it on the screen. Y'all know how I do. Y'all know how I be. I am continuing to play Assassin's Creed. So right now I'm playing Assassin's Creed 3 and I'm getting acquainted with Connor. I'm going to play Assassin's Creed 3. Then I'm going to play 4, which is Black Flag, the pirate one. And then I'm going to play Origins, Odyssey, and then I may play Mirage, which is getting ready to come out, I think, later this year, but I haven't decided yet. Because obviously those, as we go through those, they're not as old as the other games, so it won't be quite as novel, but just because everybody else is up to date with Assassin's Creed and I'm not, I think it will still be fun to do that, and I'll still put my reviews out there. I don't always review everything timely anyway, so I'll share it when I am able to share it. I'm hoping you guys will get a lot out of this and enjoy it as much as I've enjoyed making these and as much as I've enjoyed playing the games, even with my lackluster review of Revelations. So thanks for sticking around. I hope that you enjoyed this. I would love to see your comments. Did you feel the same way about Revelations, or am I just on crack? I'm not on crack really, but do I sound like I'm on crack? Who knows? Let me know your thoughts. I'm looking forward to it. If you like this video, like, share, subscribe, all the stuff you're supposed to do on the internet. Thanks for sticking around, and that's it for now.